Hey guys, so it's been a little while and actually I kind of want to like set the camera down and maybe sit down and talk for just a minute. I think that would be good. Let's see here. Okay, let's see. All right, so hi. I wasn't planning on doing this video today. I don't even know what the, my camera settings are all messed up. My camera has been in my purse for months now and I haven't used it in months. So yeah, I just realized that my camera was in my purse with me and we came over to our new house and I thought that I would give you guys a empty house tour. If you did not know, we are moving. We decided at the end of last year, probably around like, well, we knew that we were gonna move for a while just because we needed more space. Our house that we're in now, that we will be out of in a few weeks, is pretty small, and with our growing family, we needed more room. So we decided to move, and we will actually be moving into this house in the middle of March. So actually less than 3 weeks from when you guys watch this vlog. I wasn't sure how I wanted to jump back into vlogging, but it just kind of felt like it was meant to be today. That I was actually having a really rough morning. I was feeling sick yesterday. I don't know what it was. This morning I was just really upset. I have days where I go really like things are going really well, and then I can just wake up one morning and just feel extremely sad. And so this morning I was just really down, and Jeff said, hey, you know what, let's go on over to the house. And anytime we come over here, it immediately makes me feel so happy. We, like I said, we had planned on moving before anything happened on Christmas Day. And then after Christmas and everything, we decided to still go ahead and move. And I think being in our house now is really hard for me because I feel like he's missing because he was there and now he's not. And so coming over here, he's still with me, like in my heart, and it just doesn't feel as claustrophobic and sad. It's exciting, it's something new, it's something to look forward to. So sorry my viewfinder is like upside down, but anyways, I didn't mean to like I said, this was not, look at my nails. I've been picking my nails up. This was not planned. I have been crying this morning. And I also was feeling sick yesterday, so I just threw on a sweatshirt and a cap and decided to come on over to the house. So I'm gonna go ahead and give you guys a tour. Jeff is here with Cooper and Cash. They're hanging out in the backyard so that I could show you guys around. So yeah, anyways, welcome to our new house. We will be moving in less than 3 weeks, and I can't wait to bring you guys along on this journey. Comments will probably still be turned off for my YouTube videos for just a little while, just for my mental health and my sanity. So thank you guys for being here. And it feels good to be back. It feels good to be sitting down in front of the camera. Yeah, so let's go ahead and check out the new house. All right, so we're gonna go in the front door. I'm not gonna show you guys the outside of the house right now just because, but look at the flooring. Is this not beautiful? Most of you know that I redid our entire house flooring except for the master bathroom and any tile that was already there. So this floor is very comparable to what I did, except I think this is tile and the one I did was vinyl. So this flooring is beautiful. So when you walk in, this is what you see. And this house is 5 bedrooms with an office. The house that we're moving from is 4 bedrooms. So as soon as you walk in, I've never done a house empty house tour before, so I apologize if this is sucky. Let me turn up the brightness here. Let's see. Okay. So as soon as you walk in, you turn to the left and we have a linen closet right here, which, or any just storage closet, not necessarily linens. But this is important because in our house now we have zero extra space to store anything. So, and then this is the guest bathroom, or the downstairs bathroom. Never had a guest bathroom before. And I love the gray cabinets. You'll see all of the cabinets in the house are gray. No, I will not be painting painting them white. I really like the gray. I think it's beautiful. I'm just glad that they're not dark cabinets because I am not a fan of dark cabinets. This is the downstairs bedroom. I love all the natural light in this house. And then here is just a regular closet. And all of the walls in here are very light gray and the trim is white. I love, you guys know that that's like my color scheme, whites and grays. So this is actually the office. This will be mainly Jeff's office because he works from home, but I also work from home. So this is what, and I apologize for the lighting in this video because whenever my camera sees light, it gets dim. So there's a lot of bright light in this house, which is good, but also bad for videoing. And then down this way, we have the garage. And then this is also one of my favorite parts of the house. I have always wanted like a little mudroom area for the kids to hang their backpacks and to leave their shoes. So I'm so excited about this. It's so pretty. I don't know, call me crazy, but this is something I've always wanted in a house. So I'm really excited about this little area. Right here we have the laundry room, which is very interesting because the laundry room actually connects to the master closet. So if you wanna do laundry, you just take your laundry bin from here and do your laundry. You're not gonna wake up any of the kids or anything. I do laundry usually in the evening when the kids go to sleep, so this is perfect. That way, you know, the loud washer and dryer is not waking them up or anything. And it's a pretty decent space, I think, for a laundry room. And then we will go through, and this is to the master closet. From here, we are now into the master bathroom. And this is like my favorite part of the house. I love the marble countertops. And then, of course, the gray cabinets. In our bathroom now, we have zero pull-out drawers. So I am pumped about these drawers. We haven't had that. We only have cabinets at the bottom and no pull-out drawers. So that's exciting, and I know it sounds funny, but here's the bathtub. I am an avid bath taker, so this will get used every single night I take a bath. So this was a must-have for our house. If we were looking at houses and they didn't have a garden bathtub, I just couldn't do it. Like, this is my relaxing spot at the end of the night, so it's beautiful. I love the flooring in here. And then this is the master bedroom. It has these two lights up here. I'm all for the natural light in here. I love it. I've never seen like windows like this before, so I thought that was pretty cool. And then lots of natural light coming in from the backyard here. And then, yes, this does have carpet. No, I don't plan on pulling it up, but don't hold me to that. After a year or two of being in here, I might decide that I want to pull it up and continue some of this in here. In fact, I think I probably will eventually, but it's not on my to-do list right now. You can come in, but you have to be quiet because I'm talking. Okay? Hi. What? You're gonna... Okay. So here is the dining area. We don't have a formal dining room area, but that is totally fine with me. I don't typically like formal dining rooms. I just feel like they never get used. So this is where our table will go. And then this is the kitchen, which is my favorite part of the house. Every time we look at houses, the kitchen is always the first thing that I look at. And this is everything that I would want in a kitchen. I love the gray cabinets. I love the light fixtures here. I'll probably change out this light fixture, but these are beautiful. And then of course the countertops, I love the white countertops. Just beautiful. And then they have these little cutouts. We've got some white subway tiles here and then these little cutouts in the kitchen I think are really cool. I've always wanted a light or a window above the sink. But most houses that are built now don't typically see that, at least here in Texas. So they always end up putting them in the island, which is fine. But I do like that. I feel like the kitchen has a lot of open light. And then here is the pantry right over here that is actually a pretty good size. If you guys really care about what the pantry looks like. This is the living room. It's a pretty decent size. It's maybe just a tiny bit smaller than I would love. However, upstairs we do have a game room, which I feel like the kids are probably gonna spend a lot of time in. So I feel like this is probably plenty for us. And then I'm right around the corner.
Hi, buddy. We have another storage closet in here, and then we'll go ahead and go up the stairs. Mommy. Hi. Yeah, up the stairs. And Daddy. So as soon as you walk up the stairs, you walk into the game room area, and you can see here there's two windows. It's so bright. So sorry about that. Over here to the right of it, let me get my camera to focus. This is going to be Sydney's room. The reason why this one is going to be Sydney's room is because it has its own bathroom. She's the only girl in our house besides me. So she's gonna get her own bathroom, and of course she's the oldest. She's going to be 11 this year, and how cool is it to be able to have your own bathroom? So she'll have her own bathroom up here. Turn this light off. And then we walk back through the game room. So there's a bedroom on, yes baby, yes. Hi, hi. Is this gonna be your room? Do you want this one to be your room? What? So there's a bedroom here, and then the closet, a window, and then there's like this cute little cubby area right here. Okay, so here is the boys' bathroom. Can you say hi? This is the boys' bathroom. There's two sinks in here, which will be a first. All four of the kids are used to sharing one sink, so. Okay. Sorry, guys. This is a pretty decent sized bathroom. It'll be right between the two boys, well, the three boys' bedrooms. Two of the boys are actually gonna share a room. And then here's the other room. So it'll probably be Carter and Cooper together for a little while until Cash outgrows his crib, and then I'll put Cash and Cooper together. But I feel like when the kids share a room, it helps strengthen their bond a little bit. So I'm totally pro room sharing. So I don't know whose room is whose yet, but this is the upstairs. We're learning how to go down the stairs safely. Please. Good job.
No, I say please.
You say please?
Yeah.
Good job.
I'm fast.
Wow, you're fast.
I'm fast.
You're fast too?
I'm fast.
Be careful. You're like Sonic?
Yeah.
So that is it for the house tour. I apologize that I look so, I was not prepared for this video today, and I've been a crying mess. So I feel happy when I'm here, and I'm excited to bring you guys along on this new journey. It's bittersweet, it's definitely bittersweet, and I think that the day that we move will be exciting but also hard. So, I hope you guys enjoy this little tour. We are a little bit further out than we thought that we were gonna be moving. So Carter will actually be changing schools. The boys will be changing schools in the fall, and it feels good to be kind of just in a different place. And we're super excited to hopefully be back to vlogging very soon. And thank you guys so much for your support. It means the world to me. You guys have just been so kind, and I'm just so thankful. So I'll catch up with you guys in the next vlog. Bye.